A fabulous day so far. It's Zoe here from Yoga Burn. The sun is kind of messing with us a little. That's okay. I am going to walk you through three very common mistakes us women make when we are looking to flatten the tummy, pull in the core. When we're working the core, there are three very common mistakes that we can often make, and I want to walk you through these today so that you can avoid them. And hopefully, along with avoiding them, you can avoid the pain, frustration, and disappointment that comes with wasting time, energy, and money on things that don't work for us. So let's get into mistake number one. And as we're going along, be sure to say hi and let me know how your day is going so far. So number one is, you've probably seen some ladies do this. You know the exercise where you hold the weights in your hand and then you go side to side like this with big heavy weights? That is the first one. Now, mistake number three is probably the most common, so make sure you stay tuned for that one. But that exercise, you can see it's not a very flattering one. But what it's actually doing is adding bulk and thickness to the waist, because it's working the obliques that run either side of our waist here. And when we're doing weighted movements for the core, we're actually increasing the size and the thickness of the waist. So really, really important that we avoid doing any weighted movements when it comes to the core, okay? So that is mistake number one when it comes to strengthening, tightening the core. We wanna make sure we're not doing anything weighted, okay? Okay. Mistake number two is, you know when you're doing core exercises and your belly starts to puff out and you're still doing the core exercises? It's really important that we stop, freeze, take a timeout, and reset pulling in the core. Because the way that we train our core is the way that it's gonna stay. And it's important that we keep it nipped in, zipped up nice and tight for safety, but also we wanna be working that transverse abdominis. That's the deepest muscle in our core. It's important that that's trained nice and flat. If we train it and let it come forward, that means we're building that shape within our body when we're exercising. So if you don't know how to activate the transverse abdominis, the deep muscles of our core, and how to really keep and maintain that flatness, that pulled in, then be sure to tap the link in my bio and I can walk you through a routine that is dedicated to teaching you how to slim, tighten, and tone the waist by activating the deep muscle fibers in our core with very progressive movements that gradually get a little bit more challenging with time, but from a place that helps you maintain that stability in the core, which is super, super important, right? So that was mistake number two. Mistake number three when it comes to working your core is going really fast. You know when you'll see people like do the bicycle exercise? When you're going really fast, you're more prone to injury. You're more prone to the core not being held in position. You're probably not breathing properly. And you're just ruining the effectiveness of the movement. With the core, we wanna go slow. We wanna think about, it's like half of our body, our core, right? We need to really make sure we're stabilized, we're safe, and we're getting, you know, an effective workout and using the exercise, pardon me, to the fullest ability so that we're really making the most of our time. Going really fast and just banging out reps of something is not gonna get you your goals any faster. Dare I say, it would actually slow you down and hinder you. It's really important to take your time, go slow, be methodical, be very mind-to-muscle connection when you're working your core, and that's what's gonna help us get those awesome results much, much quicker than if we just speed through things. So, like I said, tap the link in my bio so I can walk you through a full core sculpting routine that you can do right from home or anywhere you like in just 15 minutes to really help you slim the waist, tighten the tummy, And flatten as well, right? Getting that pull in that hold. We use something very special called a stomach vacuum that really helps us to learn how to pull up and in and activate those muscles. So I think you'll really, really like it. So be sure to head on over there and check that out at the link in my bio. And I hope you found this video helpful. Now you know what to avoid and what to do instead, right? Have a great rest of your day. We'll talk to you again soon. Bye-bye.